Namaste guys, Ashish here and welcome to WPX Box. We have the Lumia 950 XL with us and this is the retail box. I'm going to show you what Lumia 950 XL retail box will contain. So that's how the book box looks like, and MagSafe is focused on the camera part, which is a 20 megapixel camera. We'll talk about much in detail there. And then you have the MagSafe Lumia 950 XL dual SIM. So mind it, it's a dual SIM feature. And then in the rear, it's on the front of the phone and the rich camera and the speakers everywhere, and this is what the package contains. So you do get a earphone here for those who were curious about it, along with the manual, the battery and everything else. So now let's take it out. So if I take out this box, it's very plain, simple, and it's also a huge box compared to the Lumia 640 and all, and there's a reason for that. I'm going to tell that. So this is the Lumia 950. I'm going to just take it out of that. There you go. So that's how the device looks like. We'll talk about that in a bit. First, let's take a look at the box and what's inside it. So you get a USB Type-C here, which is much required at many places for fast charging and all. And then you have the USB adapter, which is a 3 ampere adapter again, which requires, which is useful for fast charging. Now it charges up like 50% in 30 minutes. That's what I've heard about it from many users. And then you have the USB Type-C cable. Now let's take a look at the phone. Lumia 950 XL is a 5.7 inch screen phone which has a QHD display. It also feels lighter compared to the size, especially if you compare it to the 1520, which looks bigger because that's a 6 inch phone. And this might be a very comfortable phone for many those who are looking for a big size phone and still want to make sure that they can handle the phone easily. Now on the top you have the front camera, which is a 5 megapixel, shoots at 1080p, and then you have an iris scanner here, which is useful for Windows Hello, so it can take a look at your face and logs in. And then you don't have a physical button here that you should see, but there's a mic position here. You have a virtual button which you'll see when you turn on the phone. Let's take a look at the button here. This is going to be a controversial thing. The Lumia 950 XL buttons are placed in a different way. Usually you have volume knocker here, then the power button here. Instead, you have the power button, which is relatively bigger and is clubbed between the volume knockers. So this is going to be something, probably if you are handling your phone like this and you want to lock your phone and you want to unlock your phone, you can do and do that. Probably that could be a reason why they have done it, but I'm not really sure right now. And then you have the dedicated camera button here. All of these are metal buttons. Coming to the rear part, you have a 20 megapixel camera with OIS, and it comes with 3 LED flash, which means it's for RGB, which relatively helps in taking the pictures naturally. You have a speaker grill here. Now the camera is a little bumped up, which makes sure that the camera unit is safe from the accidental bump, and it also gives you speaker clearance. Now you have a Microsoft logo here, but there's no Microsoft written here, which is kind of neat. Now you have 4 array of mic on top and bottom, but when you check inside, you actually have just one that is open. On this side, it's pretty plain clean. Now to take off the rear case, you have a small notch here that you can use to take off the case here, and it comes out really nicely. There you go. So you have SIM 2 here, then you have SIM 1 here, and then you have micro SD card slot here, and this is the camera unit, and the battery is placed right below it. Now this is a user replaceable battery, so you can actually take off the battery and do this. Now this battery is basically 3340 mAh battery that you use, and then let's slide this in. Now let's take a look at the rear case here. So you have the NFC here and the Qi charging, so you get the wireless charging and NFC both on this phone. So all the qualities of the high-end phones are available here. Now I was talking about the speakers, those four dots on here. So you can see the three of them are blocked and just one is open on both the sides. So it's more of a design factor than having a four openings up there. So this is the kind of screen you take a look at when you start up your phone. Pretty simple, all these installed apps and all are shown here. And if you think these tiles are a little far away for your thumb, you can just do a long press here and it comes closer to you, so you can use your thumb here to, you know, reach those apps. Anyway, that's a nice feature. Now let's take a look at the pre-installed apps here. So you have like Amazon app, Audible, then you get Candy Crush, Clear Trip, the third party apps, and then you have Jet Airways here, then you have Ola Cabs, and then you will see Uber here, and then you have the Zomato app. So these are the pre-installed apps. So now let's take a look, how much space do you get when you first set up? Now this has already been tried here, so I'm expecting around 3-4 GB to consume, but default you get like 29 GB. So let's go to storage section here, and now there you go. So it's 4.9 GB is already used of 29 GB, so you basically have like 25 GB still with you, 24 GB. I want to take a look at the camera part here. So this shoots at like 4K. So if you go here and take a look at the camera part here, so that's the camera interface. So I'm going to take a couple of pictures, and it looks pretty decent. It's pretty fast. So what it has done is basically it's the post-processing has gone in the background, and that's why you get this saving only when you take pictures like that. So I'm going to go to the settings part here, and you can see here that it stores the picture in 16 megapixel and the video recording is 1920, but you can go up to 4K here with this setting at 24 fps. You have digital video stabilization as well, and then you can choose, you know, press and hold camera button if you want to enable, you can do that, all those stuff. So that's the camera part here. So it automatically focuses, takes picture, and if I go to video recording here, you can tap on it and it starts video recording. So that's the camera interface right now. And if I take a look at the samples here, and if I just zoom in, so I can see the clarity here on the picture has taken, but still early comments. So that's basically the camera part I've shown you quickly. Now we'll talk about it more in detail in our final review. And a few things to tell you here, Lumia 950 XL comes with liquid cooling, so the heat generally gets distributed. There is no one spot here where the phone will get heated even when you are playing games. So that's pretty cool thing. So 950 doesn't have it, but 950 XL comes with liquid cooling. That's something you should know. Now at the end, I will talk about the hardware specs quickly. So it comes with Snapdragon 810 at 2.0 GHz, and it's an octa-core phone. That's why the liquid cooling was introduced. And then you have 3 GB of RAM, 3340 mAh battery life here. And then you have optical image stabilization with the camera. And then you have rich voice recording as well on the phone. And then 32 GB of internal storage with microSD support. So guys, thanks for watching the video. If you do like the video, do hit the like button, share it with your friends, and let us know what you feel about it. Thanks for watching.